come support my good friend and very, very funny man. Can I have a round of applause for Ant?
Holes. Not entirely that funny, but I'll take your word for it. Yeah, thanks for coming, everybody. There was supposed to be kind of a stage here and a microphone and other stuff, but it didn't show, did it?
No.
Not to worry. But anyway, I thought I'd start off talking about internet dating. It's something I've got a lot of experience with. I'm single, so obviously not great experience generally. But yeah, this one girl I saw, well, I didn't actually get to meet her, but anyway, she had on a profile. She looked pretty cool, but she had a really aggressive profile. Like it was. You know, I've been hurt by guys, all men in Bristol are wankers, you know, kind of language. And it was like, okay, fair enough, but I kind of saw it as a bit of a challenge. I sent her a message and she sent me one back pretty immediately. And it, basically, she had a kind of thing going on. It had to be 100 words. Any reply to her, the initial kind of, you know, had to be 100 words, so and mine was about 40. And she basically said, you know, your heart's obviously not into this, this is 40 words. Which I took on the chin. And anyways, you know, it's like, God's sake, I actually did put effort into that. I didn't just go, hi babe, are you up for it? I replied back, taking into account that I had to use 100 words. Basically, 2 words, copied, pasted 50 times. One of the words was off. So that's internet dating. Anyone in here from Bristol?
Yay! Yay!
Okay, let me do that again. Anyone actually here from Bristol, as in,
yeah,
originally?
Yay!
Were you born in Bristol? Yeah. Oh, you just ruined my fucking joke.
Sorry.
If I was in Bristol, I would have a problem with Seven Crossing, and I'm not, and I have. But my theory is that people from Wales, they never complain about the Seven Crossing. Have you ever heard a Welsh person, apart from you, Holly, complain about the Seven Crossing? They never do. And my theory is, obviously, that when they leave Wales, they don't have to pay. So, you know, party.
Woohoo!
But when they come back, I reckon they have some kind of secret thing going on. Where I don't know, they flash their lights 3 times, you know, like doggers. I just added that in. That was
really
derive immense pleasure from other people's misfortune, which generally is me. Example of that is on the underground on the tube. You're kind of, you know, you're crushed in there like you shouldn't be, and the doors are about to close and you see a couple of people running out and the doors just close before they get there. Don't you just love that? Honestly, it's absolutely awesome. You know? And the thing is, when the doors do close and they kind of get their finger jabbed and, you know, they're generally okay afterwards. The camaraderie in the train is like, you know, we're all going to get up to the window. And then you all look out and you look up at the, you know, the next train is 12 minutes. It's like, fucking, you know. That used to keep me going in London. It's terrible. That's why I moved. But the other thing, yesterday, obviously, 100 days to the Olympics. Is anybody excited about the Olympics?
Yay! Yay!
Okay, this is why I can refer to my list. Because somebody sent me through a picture on Facebook yesterday. Big 100 in front of some kind of London, bloody, I don't know, Dubai or some shit like that. Some kind of London landmark. Now I was thinking, okay, 100 signifies the days to the big thing. But I was thinking what 100 really represents. And I've just written down here a few things, because I can't remember them and I'm cheating. So I think in 100 days is probably the actual number of tickets that were sold to the general public. The percentage of the Olympic Committee that are corrupt. Political, but probably true. The number of people watching the opening ceremony all the way through. Maybe 100, maybe that's a bit of an exaggeration. The number of years it's going to take to pay the fucking thing off. Yeah, 100. Again, that's probably... The number of people outside the M25 who actually give a shit. So, 3. Anyway, I'm looking forward to it. Can't wait. Anybody in here like travel, like going on holiday? We all do, don't we?
Yeah.
Get away from this miserable fucking country. Sorry, I added that in. I actually love this country. But I have a real thing when I'm abroad, it really annoys me. I obviously really look totally English, which, you know, is fair enough, but I was in Spain a few weeks ago, and at a bar, there's some guy in front of me who's basically skinhead, England football shirt, bulldog tattoo, you know, kind of, you know, eating a pork pie or something. Kind of looks pretty much English. The barman comes over to him, you know, hola, señor, and all this, and, you know, clearly the barman, after a few seconds, deduces that he's not actually Spanish. You know, that just really annoys me. I was stood behind this guy just as a fucking matador. Step onto the bar, he immediately says, "All right, mate, what are you drinking?" But I mean, that's an extreme example, but it's always the same. It's like, what, you know? You know, how can I try and blend in? It just pisses me off. Travel and Australia, lots of people go there from the UK, immigrants. Anybody know anyone in Australia who's emigrated?
Yeah,
we all do. Aren't they really fucking smug on Facebook?
Yeah.
It's like, it's in the UK in July, you know, it's raining outside, a bit chilly, you have to look at it. Kind of usual. They're there, you know, middle of winter there, posting pictures. Gets sunny, I'm on my terrace, it's fucking hot, I'm eating hot fucking big prawns. You know, and it's the middle of the winter, you know, the last time I was going. It's just really pissing me off. I have to tell you, I'll finish off now with another list, because it's easy and it means I didn't have to remember it. I kind of frequent internet forums because I don't get out much, and this one particular internet forum's about expats in Australia, and basically it's the one reason why what's best about Australia for expats, and the answers were hilarious and comedy, which is why I'm going to tell you. So the first one is the first single best reason why Australia is called the weather, which is, you know, I can't make a joke out of that because it's better. Does kill you, but yeah. Okay, another one. Lots of stuff to do that's cheap or free, e.g. coffee shops. Yeah, I don't know about you, I've never been to a coffee shop and had a free coffee, so... And I've been to coffee shops in Australia and they're bloody expensive, so I don't know where that came from. Okay, another one. The wife is happier here. So I'm unhappy, my kids are unhappy, but the wife's alright, so... So let's get on with that. Okay, another one. The TV is crap, so I do more in the evenings. So that's like saying, okay, I'm gonna go to Thailand because I don't ski, and I know I can't ski there. Okay, another one. I can watch UK TV online. That's a reason to go to Australia. I mean, I can just turn on my TV and kind of watch it at home. But, you know, there we go. No one knows me, so I don't have to wear makeup when I go out. I mean, go two streets out of your village and, you know, you might not get recognised. It's 18 hours away from the in-laws and they're all skinned. That is the reason. So that's me, thank you very much.
Olympics, it reminded me, I've always really liked curling as an Olympic sport, you know, that where they, sweet, you know, it's kind of like they said, yeah, athletics, but what, how can we involve the janitors?